We're going to be going over layers in this tutorial. Layers are found on the right side of the artboard, right under the Pages panel. So we're going to select Layers. When you do that, a new window pops up. On the top of the window, it has Layers, Pages, and Links. Pages, Layers, and Links are on the right side as well. You'll see that Layer 1's already there for us. That's the title of our layer. There is a little pen icon and that indicates that we're currently on a drawing level or layer so that we can actually draw on this layer. There are two boxes. The first one, when you click on it, there's a lock. What that means is when something's on this layer and the lock sign is on, you cannot take the object off of the layer and you cannot add anything to this layer and you actually cannot move anything around on this layer. So we want to take the lock off. The eyeball shows that you can actually see the layer. So when you see the eyeball, you're able to see the layer. If you can't see the eyeball, you can't see the layer. So we'll leave that on. On the bottom, there's the small square where it looks like the bottom page is turning. That icon means create new layer, and then there's a garbage can next to it. So first off, let's double click on layer one. Once we do this, a new window pops up. We can change the name of the layer. I suggest that whenever you're working on a project in class, you always change the name of the layer. If it's going to be a background color, you can name the layer background. If it's going to be a layer where you add text, you can change it to text. If it's going to be a layer of shapes, layer of pictures, you can say pictures, things like that. In this case, let's change the name to square and leave the color light blue. If you see the drop-down menu from the color, that shows the outline of the bounding box of any object on that layer. So let's go over to the rectangle tool and create a perfect rectangle. Doing that, you'll see that the outline, the bounding box of the square, matches the light blue color on the layer. Very quickly, we're going to come over and change and add color to the fill. So now even though the rectangle is yellow, there's still a blue bounding box around it. This bounding box will not show up when you actually print your object or you view it in preview mode. To give you an example, preview mode is Shift W. To do that, this shows what it's gonna look like when it prints. If you notice, there's not a bounding box around it. The bounding box just shows you the boundaries of your object. If we go over to the eye, click it off, you cannot see the layer anymore. Click it on, you can see it. And then if we lock it, you cannot move the layer. That's what the little mouse indicator is. So let's unlock the layer. So we're going to add a new layer. So go down to the bottom and do create new layer. We're going to double click on it, and we're going to name this one circle. You'll notice the color is red. So that shows that anything on this layer is going to be red. It's very important to remember that whenever you want to create something on the layer, you want to make sure the layer is selected. So right now, the circle layer is selected. We're going to come over to the rectangle tool, hold it down, go to the ellipse tool, or we can do shortcut L. We're going to create a perfect circle. Once we do that, you can see the bounding box is red, so that signifies we're on the red layer, or the circle layer. Then we'll go quickly to swatches and we'll change the color to light blue to show a better representation. All right, the important thing to know about layers is whatever is in order on the layers panel is now in order on the artboard. So right now the circle is on top of the square. On the artboard, the circle is on top of the square. Now let's move the circle over to the side. If I was to take the circle, I can click and hold on the mouse. You'll see the mouse cursor turns into a fist. That means I'm holding that layer, and a black bar appears above it. When you do that, you can click and drag down to below square and release. When you do that, the square is now above the circle on the artboard. The square is now above the circle. You can do the same thing. You can go square, click and drag below, or you can go from the bottom to the top. So that is a quick walkthrough of how to work with layers in InDesign.